going to learn about flexible manufacturing system. Flexible manufacturing system was conceptualized for machining and it was first developed by a scientist called David Williamson in 1960s. And also he has invented this FMS in the company Intersol Rand Company, which is at Virginia. And Germany country has first implemented the FMS in 1969. And also the University of Stuttgart has introduced this FMS. Russia and Japan implemented FMS in 1972. Now let us learn what is FMS. What is FMS is flexible manufacturing system. It is a flexible manufacturing system which is having a automated machine cell. It is a system which have automated machine cell which consists of group of processing workstation. It is known as an automated machine cell which is having a group of workstations which are interconnected, which are also interconnected with automated material handling and storage system. And this FMS, in this block diagram, you can see and understand more clearly about FMS. What is FMS? Here, everything will be done in one place. At one place, we will do the designing and also manufacturing. Okay, the manufacturing from process planning to the delivery of the goods and also business management can be done by using the FMS system. Okay, now if you see here, observe the figure, you can understand there is a computer control which is a main important component of the FMS system which controls all the operations. There will be a computer control and there will be humans who will operate and who will monitor as well. Okay, and also there will be loading and unloading stations where the material will be transferred to the machines and other necessary sectors where it has to be placed. Now there you can see here loading and unloading stations from where the material will be carried with the help of AGVs. And you can see AGVs, which are automated guided vehicles, which will transport the goods and material and goods from one place to another place. And these robots, we will use automated guided vehicles. You can see robots here. Okay, and you can see there will be a raw material storage. And also, if you observe, there are three workstations here. There is CNC 1, CNC 2 and CNC 3. These are the machines which are located at the same place, and the guided vehicles will move from one station to another station as per the signals received by the computer control. Now if you observe there, why we are employing this FMS in the manufacturing field. If you observe here, the first point, the external changes such as change in product design and production system. Whenever there is a change and requirement in the design which has to be made, there we can modify the changes. By modifying the program, we can modify the design at any stage of the production process. And also optimizing the manufacturing cycle time. There is no need to go and keep the material from one machine to another machine, and there is no need to change the tools because everything is done automatically, because we use CNC machines there and they are performing the actions by the given program, and there is no need of human intervention as much as we do in conventional machining system. So there is we can say there will be a the cycle time will be reduced and also reduce production cost. Where we minimize the time, there will be reduction in the cost as well. And the last one here you can see is overcoming internal changes like breakdowns and etc. As we are using automated machines there will be no breakdowns. Okay. can say these are all the advantages and why these are the benefits of employing FMS system. Now, why we are calling it as flexible? Why the name has given flexible to this manufacturing system? What do you mean by flexibility? At any stage of time in the production process, we can modify the design, and as well as we can improve any quality or any design area, or we can improve the modifications can be done at any stage of the production. And also all the works which are carried out in a manufacturing system can be carried out in one place. So we call it as flexibility. Now if you see in this slide, you can observe the ability to identify and distinguish among the different parts, types, processed by the system. When a component, we have to develop one component, we will see whether it comes under which group technology, which part family. The computer will itself give a number to that particular component. When we give the specifications, it will give one number and everything will be done automatically. And quick changeover of operating instructions. Any instructions we need to give in the middle of the production system, we can make the changes. And also quick changeover of physical setup. We can also change the setup of the machines whenever it is required. That is why we call this system as a flexible system. Now, there are different types of flexible manufacturing system. Now if you see the classification of FMS system, we have three different types of flexible manufacturing system. First one is single machine cell, second one is flexible manufacturing system, and the third flexible manufacturing cell, and the third one is flexible manufacturing system. Now let us understand in detail what are these three systems. The first one is single machine cell. Okay, now if you look at this, you can understand a single machine cell consists of one CNC machine center combined with part storage system for unattended operation. Now if you look at this figure, you can understand there is one CNC machine and everything, and there will be pallets here which you can see the goods will be transferred from one pallet to another pallet, and it will be carried out to the CNC machining system, and the work process will be carried out. After the product is developed or manufactured, then it is later on it is again moved and it is placed over on this pallets, and it will be taken to the required place. This is known as single machine cell. Now coming to the next one, then the second type of flexible manufacturing system is flexible manufacturing cell, FMC, and it consists of two or three workstations. If a manufacturing unit consists of two or three CNC machines at one place, then this type of machining system is known as flexible manufacturing cell. Two or three CNC machines placed at one manufacturing unit, then that system is known as flexible manufacturing cell, and everything will be same. Here also there will be pallets which will be moved from one station to other station whenever it is required. And the third one we call it as flexible manufacturing system, where if a system is having more than four or more workstations at one place, then it is known as flexible manufacturing system, which are controlled by the computer. Again, computer control, and that computer control also, if you see here, you can understand. A flexible manufacturing system has four or more processing workstations connected mechanically by a common part handling system and electronically by a distributed computer system. There will be more on workstations which are controlled by the computer system and also material handling system. Now let us see what are the basic components of FMS, the components or elements of the FMS. The basic element of the FMS's workstations, where there will be workstations means machines will be placed, and also there will be automated material handling system and storage systems which move the goods or material from one workstation to another workstation or to the required place. And also computer control system, which is a main element in the FMS system, which the computer will control all the necessary functions which are carried out in the manufacturing systems. And there will be substations. Substations are nothing but the machines which are in the workstations. There will be so many. There will be also some substations which will also perform the machining operations. And also loading and unloading. These substations will be in workstations. The first one is loading and unloading stations, machining stations, other processing stations, and assembly. These are the four sections in the stations are known as substations, which are also connected with the workstations. Now coming, let us by looking at this, observing this figure, we can have an idea what is material handling system and how does it work. Now automated fork lifting and rail traveler are the examples we can see in this slide. The next component of the FMS is computer control programmable logic controller. Computer control will control all the functions which are carried out of the manufacturing system. It will control, and also as we know there will be a program which will run the machining process, and also logic control which will perform as per the given specifications. It will perform the operations. If you observe the figure, you can see there is a PLC programming, PC. There is a computer which controls all the logic operations. As we have learned, it will control all the operations, and it is connected internally. If you observe this diagram, you can observe there is some hardware and software which is connected with the PC, which does the actual work. There will be a CPU, memory which stores, and also an input processing circuit, output processing circuit, expansion connection, communication, power supply. All this is known as PLC controller. PLC controller will consist of all these parts which are connected with the computer control, programmable logical control. Now coming to, if you observe this figure, you can understand how the flexible manufacturing system will be. If you observe, this is manufacturing system which are having more than four or more than workstations, then how it will be? There will be automated guided vehicles, CNC workstations, substations, and automated guided vehicles which move over the rolls here, rails, and also machining centers. There will be wash stations, control rooms, CMM for inspection and control, and also storage systems, and also loading and unloading stations. This all combined collectively, they are placed in one place, and they will perform all the activities to make the raw material into a final product. It is known as flexible manufacturing system. Machines, FMS for machine. If you observe this, you can also understand how in real time how the flexible manufacturing systems will be. Now you may be having doubt, everything is controlling by the computers. Is there any need of humans there? Yes, there is a human requirement in the FMS as well. Then how, in which way they are used in the FMS system? If you observe this, you can know typically perform the jobs which are performed by humans. First one, loading raw work parts into the system. Though there are automated guided vehicles there, but somebody has to pick and place there. And nowadays robots are used, placed for pick and place. But also there will be a human who monitor everything. So there is a human requirement in the FMS system. And also unloading parts and also changing and setting tools, everything will be carried out automatically. But if there is any requirement, there will be a human will be present there to observe and monitor all the functions. And also equipment maintenance and repair. If anything goes wrong and any repair work has to be done, then there will be humans who will be doing that work. And also the part programming, NC part programming, the manually they will prepare one program and they will insert. Layouts of FMS. There are different types, different layouts, how the machines and automated guided vehicles and how the quality control are placed in one system. So now let us stop here, and tomorrow we will continue. Thank you.